Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot, and today we're going to play a little bit of the Elegy for a Dead World beta. Now, this is a game I recently backed on Kickstarter, mainly because it had a very interesting concept, and it is freaking beautiful. To explain the concept is a very difficult thing. I'm not 100% sure I understand how the game works myself, but the idea, as far as I know, is it's this exploration around these beautifully crafted planets and worlds and stuff. And you get these opportunities to craft a story and a tale around the experiences that you're witnessing. And if you love it, at the end you get the opportunity to print your own book and all this kind of stuff. It's just an interesting concept. Write a new story, okay. Yeah. Ooh! Now this is only... Okay, this is crazy for me. Choose a writing prompt. Dark couplets. Okay. Duh. Ooh, how gorgeous is that? I'm just putting this out there. This game is insanely beautiful. It's disgusting. You can just sit down if you want. Just have a little chill. Not bad. Ooh, it's gorgeous. You know what it really reminds me of? The cover of one of Fight Star's albums. Press tab to write. Okay. Oh. Blood, stone, something rock, broken something. So basically, yeah. Your character's going around and witnessing this landscape and this beautiful alien planet, and you just kind of write what you want and craft this tale, and at the end you view it, and that's about it. This is only the beta, so obviously not everything's accessible. I mainly went for it because it's about writing, and that's pretty cool, and it's stunningly beautiful. Blood, stone, blackened rock. I'm just going to make stuff up. A broken clock. So basically, the idea is let's look around what we're looking at here and just try to interpret it as a story as we would see it. It's kind of like filling the blanks. It's like, what are those things called? Where you put in like words and then they put them into a story. It's meant to be a funny little story, like a silly man went to buy a poop hat, that kind of thing. But obviously not quite that. I mean, you could do it. You could do a poop clock if you wanted. I don't really want to go that way. I actually prefer it like that. Dadum? Ah. Chatham. Terrifying. Let's have a little wander. Ooh. So there's 10 things. Rubble, rubbish. Now, I do feel like on the spot because I need to write and pretend that I can conjure up words, but in my defense, it is currently 4:37 in the morning. So what have we got around? We've got rubble and rubbish and towers, and the towers, they're in the distance, they're kind of pointy. I'm not using the word pointy here, that would be silly. Is that even how you spell dilapidated? 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 I'm gonna stick with that. I don't think that's even how you spell.
Jarum?
I just love it for the noise effects. It also reminds me of, I don't know if anyone played Another World. Was it called Another World? I can't remember. The terrifying game where you kind of walk across and there's this black beast thing stalking you across the planet. Terrified me. Faces metal. Oh, okay. This kind of looks like a gold, like the head. I'm pointing at my screen. Suddenly aware that you can't see it, obviously. It's like a golem kind of buried under the earth, maybe. Faces metal. Ah, buried threat. An angry construct. I want everything to rhyme, so faces metal, a buried threat, an angry threat met. Wet doesn't really work. That doesn't make any sense, but it rhymes. On we go. This is... I was actually tempted to do a playthrough of this game when it hits, but it feels like quite a personal experience in a way. It's like how you envision the world, and it's something I think you need to sit down and take some time with and kind of imagine these. They've given you the canvas, and now you need to kind of make your own world around it, kind of thing. So this is like a tomb. Intact. Encased. So what's encased? In. In's a good start. The Rock off those who fell. I'm just gonna write rubbish now, and we're gonna see it all come together at the end and see if it makes any sense. Fell, Mel, Kel, Lel, Nell, Del, Pell. Not much rhymes with fell. Wait, can I get rid of tomb? Oh, I can. So basically, these words like suggestions, but you can actually just craft your own complete thing. Hell is the only word I could think of that actually fit there. So far, we've got these ancient constructs of metal, right? And they've got like this need that hasn't been met, remember that a bit? And we're encasing them in the tombs to kind of keep them down. And this is like the defensive thing. It's very loud and very shiny. Okay, you're too loud, I need to get away from you. Bugger off, please. You're beautiful, though. How gorgeous is this game? I just want to play just to look at... I'm going to start walking instead of doing my little hobby thing. It's just beautiful. I'll have a little sit down. Chill for a little bit. Good stuff. Good stuff. Ooh, can I go inside? Ooh. Ooh. God, I love this game already. There's little reflections on the pottery. Uh-oh, something's gone down. Inside, preserved. Nothing's been preserved. Ah. Mon... Black. Knack. Lack. Smack. Smackdown! No, smack, lack, knack, track. Track, Mac, quack, rack. It's so hard to do this under pressure. Oh god, inside, preserved. So what's inside, right? So inside, preserved. Also it means this, well nothing's been preserved. I can get rid of the word black there. So what's this thing on the wall, right? So far we've got this world, these golems came up and they started trashing shit, and the people came together at the end to like put up this radiating light thing that shoves them on the ground and powers up the temple thing that contains these war golems of the past. If that were to happen, who would put that mark on the wall? Because obviously a golem didn't do it. It's got to be like an anarchy symbol maybe. Or the spiritualist angle, who don't believe in the technology, they just want to ward off the evil using wards. Dead, fed, Ned Stark. No. Dead, Ked, Led. No, Med. Mediterranean? No, it doesn't really fit here. Bed. So these anarchists, maybe they don't want, maybe they're trying to go against technology, maybe they want the golems to take over the planet. They're like, oh, it's nature's way and all this stuff, so. Wards of black tar and paint. Rise the golems from their earthly bed. Full stop. Jadam. Can maybe go all the way back? Fine. I've got super sneaky fly mode. So cool. So cool. I've taken to backing a lot more stuff on Kickstarter just because you find little gems like this. Games that, under normal rules of game design, stuff like this couldn't exist because it's not really even a game. It's just an interactive experience. I love that. I love that stuff like this gets made. If you think about it, I don't think 10 years ago, 20 years ago, this kind of stuff could be made. So away from the city, nature has begun to kind of surge As the city's been abandoned, right? Everyone died, pretty much. They managed to stop the golems, but they couldn't stay around because this agony, that kind of, this constant turmoil, and they've been through too much. They have to get away. You know, they're running away from their past. So nature has started to kind of take over the world that was. Roots and what was it? Roots and life. Mother Earth. I sound like a hippie. Nature returns. So what? So what though? There needs to be a bit of conflict. It's like a mini story within a bigger story. So what's the conflict with Earth coming back? And how am I going to rhyme with kingdom? Oh no. That doesn't even make sense. I'm just going to write it anyway. Kingdom, fiefdom, dum. Maybe we just need to rhyme with dum. Shin, lun. We're going to go a little like off the rhyming thing here. Kingdom, dundum, fiendum, lindum, humdum, humdrum, tum, dum, dum, shun, nun, nun, nun. That's silly. It can't be nun. New London. New London, because this is like a new fancy planet, right? So the people who did claim this planet in the first place came from London, you know? And they decided to call it New London, like people called it New York and that kind of stuff. Based, I assume New York was based after New York, by the way. New York's awesome, by the way. York's better than New York. I'm just putting this out there. I don't like New York, but York's a beautiful little place. What's this here? Just a rock. Yeah. Ooh, a little hut. Love me a little hut. I've been known to love many a hut in my time. So, so this is, what would this be? So this is a hut kind of in the outskirts of the city, away from, you feel like this is going to be the people who are trying to raise the golems back up, hence all the golem faces. These like triangle, curved triangles with the T's, these are the golem heads. They're trying to raise them back up, so they're off living in the outskirts of the city, doing ventures into the New London, New London, as it should be called, and painting the tar marks and stuff, and all this black magic to try and prevent the technology from halting the spread of these monsters. Home, sanctuary. So what would it be? Home, sanctuary, what would it be? It's the place where they go and prepare stuff. I'm just going to call that a place of black. I hate the word black magic as well, it feels really cheap. A dish from the others. Magic, tragic. Tragic. How can I make tragic fit here? How do I make tragic fit? Tragic. This is what I mean. This is not a playthrough kind of game. I need to sit here for half an hour and craft a thing. What I'll probably do for a main playthrough is do the whole thing on my own time and then kind of show you guys the finished article. I guess. A dish from the others. Them. This city. Magic. Tragic. I don't know why it has to rhyme, by the way. It's a story. It shouldn't have to rhyme. But now I've started it, it has to rhyme. It'd be a bit weird if it's 7 out of 10 rhyming. Actually, I don't know if the first two did. And then it just stops. That doesn't make any sense. Tragic. How do you fit tragic at the end of a sentence? That's the problem. It can't. Magic. Right, so let's change that around. Let's just rhyme with jick. Not going for the obvious. Them, the city, those dicks. Jick, lick, nope. Nick, they're taking the mick. Fick, trick. Jadam. Ooh, I can walk outside. Maybe I'm not. Wee. Dead. Oop. No, I didn't mean to do that. Oh, another hut. This better be a better hut. You a better hut. I'm gonna say you're a better hut. You're an okay hut. As huts go, I like you. You're not my favourite hut. You mean the worst hut I've ever been in. When you go inside, it kind of loses the atmosphere of that sky in particular. Primitive. Worship. See, he kind of is fitting with what I was going for. Worship. An ode to the lost gods. Gods. Mods. Dods. Trods. Pods. Pods. Pods, 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 pods. Nah. Zods. Lord Zod, we could get some Superman on the go. Begots. Begots. Baguettes. France. France. Vive la Revolution. No, it doesn't really work. Primitive. Worship. An ode to lost gods. A prayer for the beneath. Slot. Nods. Nods. Mods. Bods. Odds. Cards. Four. Trots. For gods. Mods. Moblods, blib blob libs, blub blubs, blobs. Blobs works, but maybe not. I don't know how I'd fit blobs into this, really. There's always a way to fit blobs into everything. What am I about? Frog and. Frogs, cogs. That'll do. Chatham? Don't know what the Chatham's about, but I like it. Ooh, hello. You're a large one, aren't you? I'm trying to get a good look at my character, but every time he turns around, he faces the other way. It's very irritating. Although, got some serious dance moves, that's something. Bam, bam, bam. No, okay. It's a serious game, best of slot. Treated like a serious game. Only one more to. Ooh. It's like a graveyard of. I wonder what this would be then. Yeah, it's a grave, right. So what have they tried to do? These are the people out in the outskirts, so maybe they've been crafting these heads, like, resembling the heads of the golems who were buried under the earth as kind of like a way to. It's like a tribute to their old gods before technology came and kept them down and then forged this new London city and the gods came back, but technology managed to hold them back yet again, and now the world's in like perpetual teetering on the balance between this prison holding them all down and the power of these old golden gods rising back up. But it's a dead world and there's no one here to see it. World, curled, furled, milled, pearled, twirled, 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 twirled. Unfurled. Church grave, a dead plane for a dead world. Milled, furled, unfurled, unfurled works, unfurled's gonna work here. Jadam? jam. I'm going to keep doing that for the rest of my life now. Ooh, okay. Hey game, stop being gorgeous. Untitled by Bessonstart. Bloodstone, Blackened Rock, a broken poop clock. I thought I changed that. Oh no. I didn't realise I kept that. Okay. I can't believe that's ruined it so badly. And the second one doesn't rhyme. I'm going to start from here. Okay. Faces, metal, a buried threat, an angry construct with needs not met. These are the people trying to summon the old gods, right? So the needs, how to get them back, hasn't been met yet. Intact, encased in the rock of those who fell, a tomb observed knows from hell. Radiating, alive, a beam of incandescent light, halting the growth of the beasts below, containing their might, don't like that. Inside, preserved, remnants of culture long dead, wards of black tar and paint, rise the golems from their earthly bed. That was better. Roots, life, Mother Earth reclaims her kingdom, nature returns suffering. That doesn't... Does it rhyme? Kingdom, London-ish. Roots, life, Mother Earth reclaims her kingdom, nature returns, suffocating New London. Don't like that. Home, sanctuary, a place of black magic, a dish from the others, them, the city, metal and lightning into a cheap trick. Primitive, worship, an ode to the lost gods, a prayer for the beneath, those of steel and cocks. Church, grave, a dead plane for a dead world, watching in silence as the story unfurled. This game is awesome! Oh my god, should we read someone else's? I'm so excited. Okay, this one's weird already. Okay, we're just going to do this, and then we're done. This is by Galatea. Galatea, if you happen to watch this, top stuff. I'm going to high-five you in a minute somehow. A closed eye, crushing me, crushing the world, crushing us. Our eyes never met at the same level. You are obscured, not meant to be. Now out of reach, running. The tower crushes us all when it crumbles. Alive, shamed. The signs we don't want to read crumble and fade through my fingers. Tombstone fingers that will never reach. The hellish landscape is one untouched. Consume me on my own. We cannot bear it. What can't we bear? We can't bear or bear. Both ways. My own executioner, from which we hung. I hooked these bones to remember you. Bloody hell, leave me on hooks. No. I don't want to recommend that. Bloody Nora. One more by Dodo. Welcome to the world. I'm tired already. Ovaltine. Drink. Hey. Okay. So, the idea, I suppose, is that the community behind the game is going to build these loads of stories, and you can go around and read other people's and see what they've constructed. Oh my god, is that another one? No, it doesn't look like it, actually. Oh yeah, I don't think so. But, you saw at the end, it said publish what you can do. There's like a service, and basically what they'll do is they'll print like an art book containing your story. I think it's really cool, and I'd love to spend a little bit longer writing it. I couldn't spend forever doing it, and it felt a bit weird, I've got to be honest, doing it in the recording. But it's very, very cool, this, and it's gorgeous, and I cannot wait to get the full game when it comes out. Because I should get a copy. I should get a copy as soon as it comes out, and we'll do something on it. I'm not really sure what yet, but we'll do something. Anyways, thank you very much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. This has been Elegy for a Dead World. Was it Elegy? Elegy. We're going to go with Elegy. Got hiccups again. Bloody hell. Elegy for a Dead World. This has been on Kickstarter recently, but I'm sure it'll hit Steam, Greenlight or something like that. There'll be a way for you to back it. Either way, I think it's a game everyone should be keeping an eye on. It's gorgeous. It's interesting. It's unique. It's doing something different in the gaming landscape, and that should always, always, always be supported. If that different thing has any merit, which in this case it clearly does, because look at it! I loved that. That was a lot of fun. That was cool. Cool. Cheers. Much love. Bye-bye.